See this question. A CPU has a 5-stage pipeline and runs at 1 GHz frequency. What does it mean, 1 GHz frequency? Actually, that is called clock rate. Okay. So the relation between clock rate and clock cycle time, we'll see. Generally, one clock cycle time, if you want to find out in your computer, that is exactly equal to 1 by clock rate. Okay. This is the formula. So here 1 by clock rate is nothing but 1 GHz. Giga means 10 to the power of 9, hertz means 1 by second. So it is second inverse. If it goes up, it will become second. So answer is, that's why in the seconds. And 1 by 10 power 9, which is nothing but 10 power minus 9. So 10 power minus 9 seconds. So finally we got clock cycle time, which is nanosecond, right? Clock cycle time. 10 power minus 9 means 1 nano, right? 1 nanosecond. Remember it. Now read the remaining question. What is that? Instruction fetch happens in the first stage of the pipeline. We know that. A conditional branch instruction computes the target address and evaluates the condition in the third stage. He is telling that there are 5 stages. And if it is conditional instruction, then the instruction execution will be here. He is clearly mentioning that in the third stage, so that target will be calculated, target address, and computes the target address and evaluates the condition in the third stage. Fine, this is third stage. That means after the third stage we will get the target address. Now remaining question: the processor stops fetching new instructions following a conditional branch until the branch outcome is known. See, branch outcome is known here, then by that time we are not fetching any new instruction. So freshly we are starting the fetching. So remaining details are unnecessary, sir. How such things will be implemented doesn't matter for us. So fetch, decode, execute, in that way it will start again. So what I want to say is, generally if this is not conditional instruction, then we would have had like this, right? Then we would have had overlapping. When you have overlapping, then I can say that each instruction is effectively taking only one clock cycle time, correct? Otherwise one stage delay, correct? We know that. Let me emphasize this point. What is that is, if your pipeline goes in full-fledged, then every, because we are sharing the stages, so that for every stage delay we are getting one instruction out. Already we have seen, correct? I can say that in that scenario, for every stage delay, here what is the stage delay? Did they mention anything? We will see. So if you see this one, he has clearly mentioned that if each instruction takes one cycle time, each instruction takes one cycle to complete on average. Okay, that means what he is telling, that here your instructions takes exactly one cycle, but generally we know that it is one stage delay, but in the problem they said one cycle. That means each stage taking one cycle. Now from now onwards, each instruction takes only one cycle time. But unfortunately, because of unconditional instructions, sometimes there will be a penalty, extra penalty. Okay, we are focusing on that point. If there is no conditional branch, we will be very happy because your pipeline will be like this, correct? So that for every stage delay, example, this is one, already they have mentioned that every instruction is coming out after one cycle because they are taking only one clock cycle time, correct? So if that is the case, so each instruction is taking only effectively one clock cycle, right? But if it is conditional instruction, what happens, we'll see. If it is conditional, fetch, decode, execute, memory, write back, then rather than fetching here, we fetch here, correct? Then only we know the target. When you fetch here, then what is happening? What is normal? Normal is fetching here. Rather than fetching here, if you fetch here, then how many clock cycles you wasted, you see. So if you fetch here, then see, everywhere overlapping, correct? You can decode here, you can execute here, and you can do memory, you can do write back, right? So what I want to say is, if you fetch here, then obviously every instruction takes only one clock cycle. But you did not do that. What you did? You fetched here. So because of that, what is going to happen is, so here this place is empty, you wasted it. This place is empty because of that. If you see the timings, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The next instruction should take only one clock cycle, correct?
But how much time it took? 6. That means rather than 6, memory write back. See, 6, 7, 8. The next instruction came after 8 clock cycles instead of 6. That means 2 cycles we got extra in the instruction execution time. If you have so many such kind of conditional instruction, because of every conditional instruction, you get extra 2 cycles penalty. So finally, penalty is very important. Now, how much penalty we are getting? Just 2 extra cycles, right? Now, let us go to our problem again. What is the problem, remaining problem? The processor stops fetching new instructions following a conditional branch until the branch outcome is known. Yes, fine, we understood that. A program executes 10 to the power of 9 instructions, out of which 20% are conditional branches. Fine. So, I can say that out of all that instructions, whatever, they said 10 power 9, you remember that, 20% are conditional branches and 80% are normal instructions, right? Now, if each instruction takes 1 cycle to complete on average, the total execution time of the program is, he said that there are 20% conditional instructions, and we know the penalty of conditional instructions, 2 extra cycles. Okay, now we can solve this problem like this. 2 extra means what? They will have their own 1 cycle. Apart from that, 2 more extra cycles it is giving the penalty. Now we can use this formula for instruction execution time. See, all the instructions, all that instructions are having 1 clock delay, correct? 1 cycle time, remember it. Now I am calculating the average instruction execution time. It is 1 cycle time plus some penalty. How much penalty? The penalty is 2 extra clock cycles, right? 2 cycle times. But not, you know, for every instruction do you have 2 extra penalty? No. For how many instructions? Only 20%, right? I can say like this. That's why 20% of time you are getting 2 extra cycles. Sir, what is this 1 cycle? It is the general penalty when you execute instructions in pipeline. So every instruction takes 1 cycle time. That is clearly mentioned in the question. So that's why 1 cycle. Apart from that, these 20% branch instructions are taking 2 more cycles. Then how much, how many cycles an average instruction will take? 1 cycle plus 20% of 2 cycles. It will be 22 is a 40, 40 by 100, which is nothing but 1.4, I think, right? 1.4 cycles on average. Okay, so this is about, you know, cycle, number of cycles, otherwise cycle time, 1.4 cycles, right? But you want to know, if you see the question, in the question they are asking the total execution time. I want execution time. You have cycle time, you see, clock cycle time 1 nanosecond. You have 1.4 cycles. Then how much time they will take? 1.4 cycles. Cycle time is nanosecond, then 1.4 nanosecond. It will become 1.4 nanosecond. But question is not about one instruction. Program has 10 to the power of 9 instructions. Then how much time they will take? 10 to the power of 9 instructions. Each instruction on average takes 1.4 cycles, each cycle time nanosecond. So 1.4 nanosecond, it would become, nano 10 power 9 cancel, it will become 1.4 seconds. That's why execution time is 1.4 second. Now we have another method. So don't get confused, because in some of the places you might see this formula. See how it is 80%, 20%. We can classify like this. 80% instructions are normal instructions, 20% instructions are conditional instructions. Let us do separately. So 80% of the instructions, if you see, they are not definitely branch instructions, then they will require only 1 clock cycle. Understand? Now, 20% of the time, they are branch instructions, they are having 1 clock cycle as usual plus 2 penalty. So 2 clock cycles. I can say that 20% of the time, 3. So if you see 80% of, sir, what is the this formula is for what? Average number of clock cycles required to instruct execute one instruction, right? So 80% of the time 1 clock cycle, 20% of the time 3 clock cycles. If you use this formula, you get what? Average clock cycles, correct, for instruction. Then 80% of 1 clock cycle, so it will become 0.8. So I use one, you know, one clock cycle is, let's say, x. The one clock cycle is x.
then 80% of x plus 20% of 1 into 2. If you simplify, 80% into x plus 20%, see this 1 plus 2, I can write 3x, correct? 1x plus 2x. Okay, if one clock cycle is x, one cycle plus two cycles is 1x plus 2x. Then 20%, I can simplify like this, 20% into x plus 20% of 2x. Now 80 by 100 into x plus 20 by 100 into x is 100 by 100 into x, that's why it will become x is nothing but one clock cycle. I replace that again, one clock cycle plus 20% of the time, 2x, two clock cycle, you get same formula, understand? So there is no difference, right? So this is the way you can, you know, answer this question at a problem, right? So one more way of solving this problem is like this. First of all, how many instructions you have? 10 to the power of 9, correct? So in 10 to the power of 9, 80% of the time you can do like this, 10 to the power of 9 instructions, out of them 80% of them are like this. In 10 to the power of 9, 20% of them is like this. So 10 to the power of 9 into 10 to the power of 9, out of them 80% instructions takes how much time? One clock cycle. One clock cycle means 1 nanosecond. Directly we can substitute 1 nanosecond plus 10 to the power of 9 instructions into, out of them 20% are branch. They take how much time? One clock cycle as it is plus two extra clock cycles penalty. So three clock cycles. Then each clock cycle takes 1 nanosecond. Then 3 clock cycles takes 3 nanosecond. Then if you simplify again, you get same answer, which is 1.4 second. Okay.